A very important element of your paper or your thesis is the introduction. It's really, really important because this is arguably one of the first things that your reader will come into contact with when they start reading your paper or thesis. This is also the place where you establish the context, where you interest the reader, and where you state the aim of your paper. So obviously it is very, very important. That's why I want to give you four necessary elements that you need to include in your introduction section. This will help you write your introduction much, much faster because you will have an easy to follow template that you can basically use to write your introduction. And it will also make your introduction much better organized and clearer for the reader. So let's get started. Before we get into it, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that little bell button so you don't miss any of my future videos. And if you're new here, my name is Marek Kiczkowiak and I run academicenglishnow.com, where I help university students and researchers write better theses and papers. So, what are the four necessary elements that you need to include in an introduction? And I'm saying necessary because every introduction, regardless of the field that you're in, whether you're doing molecular biology, nuclear physics, English language teaching, or anthropology, or whatever else you're doing, each thesis or paper, each introduction will have these four elements in the order that I'm going to give them to you. So the first element is establishing the importance of the topic. This kind of includes as well providing the background and the context for your study. But very, very importantly, you need to show us why this particular thing that you're doing is important. The importance can be for society in general. For example, water shortages have become one of the major problems that many countries in the world are dealing with. So you can use phrases like a major problem, a major cause of. Another very typical phrase is play an important role in. You can also establish the importance of the topic for your discipline and for your researchers. So there are different ways in which you can do this, but that's definitely the first element that every good introduction needs to have. Now, afterwards, you need to briefly review the literature. Now, a quick side note here. So some introductions will contain the full literature review, and in other fields, the introduction and literature review will be separate. Whatever the case may be in your particular field, and always check with other papers or check with your supervisor, check other theses that have been written to see what people do in your field. But whatever the case might be, you still need to briefly review the literature in your introduction after you've established the importance of the topic. So you need to basically tell us what is already known about the topic, what the researchers have found about this particular topic that you're doing. And remember, you've got to be very, very specific here because you don't really have much space in the introduction. So pick the studies very, very carefully. Element number three is to establish the research gap. So first you've presented what is already known about the topic, right? And then you tell us what is still lacking, the research gap. And this is very, very important because if you don't have a research gap, you don't have an aim. And this means you don't really have a thesis or a paper. There are different ways of presenting the research gap, and I've explained them in another video. You can find the link right below here. But one of the main ways is to show that, for example, there has been a lack of research in a particular geographical region, or a lack of particular type of research that has used a particular methodology. Another way of establishing the research gap might be to, for example, point out what the problems or limitations are with the previous studies. And finally, the last element that every introduction needs to have Element number four is obviously stating the research aim. And there are three main ways in which you can do this, and I posted another video about this earlier on, and you can see the link right below here. But just very quickly, the first way would be to state it as an aim, as a statement of aim. So this paper aims to. You could also write research questions, and then finally you could write it as a hypothesis or a prediction. So just to sum up, the four elements that you really must include in every introduction to a paper or thesis are establishing the importance of the topic, presenting what is already known, so briefly reviewing the literature, establishing the research gap, and then finally element number four, stating the aim of your paper. So if you follow these tips and these elements one by one, it'll be much easier to write your literature review, you'll write it faster, and it will be much better organized as well. If you want more tips like that and you want to start improving your academic English right now, then definitely take a look at my Instant Better Academic Writing Challenge, where in just 10 minutes a day for the next 5 days, you can significantly improve your academic writing and write better thesis and papers, and the link is right below this video.